Controls are increasingly utilized in order to improve the comfort, flexibility, and quality of your lighting. We talked about controls for energy saving in a separate video. Now we're going to tell you what you can do with the controls to improve the flexibility and comfort of your lighting. Scene setting is a good example of flexibility. This is where different combinations of switching the light fittings, dimming, and even color change are used to give a different appearance to a room. Changing the scenes can be done simply by pressing a button. For example, you can dim the lights beside a presentation screen, or you can add extra illumination to pictures on walls. This technique is often used for meeting rooms and boardrooms. In an office which has direct or indirect luminaires, you can sometimes alter the amount of light emitted upwards and downwards independently. For example, with suspended or freestanding luminaires, more upward light gives a soft appearance. Alternatively, mainly downward light gives the space more contrast with high illumination on the horizontal surfaces such as desks and lower illumination on the walls or on people's faces. Many light fittings nowadays have the facility to change the light color appearance from warm to cool. This is often linked with dimming. Lighting schemes which include elements of circadian rhythms often use these two features together. For example, some activities might require high light levels and cool white light. Later in the day, you may wish to reduce the light level and move to a warmer appearance. In large offices and factories, you can achieve extra flexibility by grouping the luminaires into zones. This is an advantage where you might want to subdivide the space at a later date. Of course, controls can also be used to produce color change effects on, for example, building facades. As you can see, once we start combining dimming with color hues and directional lighting for both indoor and outdoor, our visual space starts to get very interesting indeed.